to change the world.
The man once said. To this, the woman replied.
Don't go.
I need to do this.
He said gravely, his penetrating gaze searching her mind through her eyes.
For truth, justice, love, and life, I know.
She whispered almost to herself, her head resting firmly on his chest. He smiled at this. She knew him better than he knew himself. He gently brushed a single tear away from the woman's face with his thumb, almost as if to say the tear was just as lonely as they were feeling at that moment.
I'm not gone.
As he said this, he pulled away to place his hand over her heart.
Not here.
Then stay, or let me come with you.
She cried pleadingly.
You know the answer, my love.
He replied softly.
This is a journey you must take alone, I know. But why?
She'd been crying for some time. I was tired from it. I'd like to have another vodka martini.
Shaken or stirred?
I'll give you a hit. I'm not James Bond.
That's what it is.
He leaves and ends up getting killed by a poacher in the wilderness. True story. Happened to a good buddy of mine.
Bullshit. That can't be the whole story.
Fine. Where was I?
You were at This Is a Journey You Must Take, right?
Right. She exclaimed desperately.
Don't. I'll be just the way you are.
He looked into her eyes. He had a calming effect on her.
I'll come back. I promise. And when I do, I'll spend the rest of our lives together.
She sighed resignedly.
It's not fair.
I'll make it up to you for the rest of our lives. I promise.
He replied with sincerity.
Attention all passengers. Train 109 is now boarding. Please present your boarding pass.
Whoa. Hold on there. We're in a train station?
It's the magic of storytelling. Let me continue.
That's my train.
The man said. His heart wishing he could stay, but his mind telling him it was time to go. They kissed passionately, their last for a long while. Then she looked at him, a fresh tear in her eye. She wiped it away, wishing to be strong for her lover. Once again, the voice of a female attendant could be heard on the intercom.
Final call for train 109. All passengers must present their boarding pass and gate to the immediately.
He knew that if he didn't leave right now, he would have second thoughts about leaving. With that thought, he gave her one last kiss and walked away in the direction of gate 12. That was the last time he saw her alive. Now if you excuse me, I got places to be.
Well, honestly, I don't know what to believe.
It's the truth.
Well, what the hell, man? Where's the rest of the story? My buddy!
She is the greatest person I've ever known. I called her my Mayflower. She was born in May. She used to tell me, I'll go anywhere with you. All this feels strange. My love, where you've gone, I cannot follow. I spent the last few years without her. I told myself it was for our future. What a fool I was. She was my future. A few days ago, I got a call from her mother telling me she had died of cancer. Found a lump in her left breast about a year ago. She never once told me in any of her emails, phone calls. I suppose she wanted me to remember her the way she once was. Happy, healthy and beautiful. She was always doing that. Trying to make other people happy. Going out of her way to help others. Guess that's why I fell in love with her in the first place.
Nathan Martini?
This flower was fine 2 days ago, but now it's dying.
I'm sorry about your loss, son.
Why would it die so suddenly?
Listen, there's no easy way for me to say this. But you had a father.
He didn't know you existed.
Had?
You don't miss a beat, do you, son? Just like your old man. He's He's dead. It happened yesterday.
Your mother, God rest her soul, didn't want me to tell him anything about you.
Now it's too late.
I'd like you to come with me. I want to show you who your father was.
Okay.
All this feels strange.